Hello everyone, today you are listening Chanakya in You, written by Radhakrishnan Pillai. Grandpa's advice. Once had a very loving grandpa. I guess all grandpas are loving, but the bond I shared with my grandpas was different. First of all, I had only ever known one grandpa in my life, the father of my father. Also, I was brought up in metropolitan city, while my grandparents lived in a village. So every vacation I look forward to visiting them. It was a special event for both me and my grandparents. They waited eagerly for their grandchildren to come home and spend time with them. As a child, I knew that with them around me, no one in this world would dare object to my pranks, not even my own parents. I had full freedom to do whatever I want. There is a saying, why are grandparents and grandchildren close to each other? Because they have common enemy in between. So the bond between these two generations is very unique. While you are a parent, you are burdened with so many responsibilities that it is difficult to dedicate enough quality time to your kids even though you really want to. As for our grandparents, since they have all the time in the world, they need someone to pass their love and experience to. They find life fulfillment in their grandchildren, and the kids in turn look forward to receiving their wisdom in the form of stories, long walks in the garden, fields and marketplaces. My grandpa was master storyteller. He had so much to tell us. While many of these stories were from his own life, most of them were from lives of others. He would lead us to his library, which was full of books, while Grandma was busy in the kitchen preparing a variety of delicious for everyone. At the time, my cousin and I not really interested in books he held so dear. At his library was amazing. It was his private den, with neatly arranged books classified and categorized in each cupboard and neatly labeled. He even showed us a register where he mentioned a list of type of books he had, from science to world literature and poems to paintings. He had books spanning a wide range of interests. But I was far more interested in listening to his stories than reading those heavy, wordy books. Besides, Grandpa had knack for recalling events from different books he had read and weaving them into stories that we as kids could understand. One of my senior cousins, who was very studious, once asked him, "Grandpa, what is more important, reading books or listening stories?" "Both," he said with great enthusiasm. "Not everybody has interest and patience to read books, but everyone likes to listen to stories. And you will find that when you pay attention to the story, you will never be the same person again." But given that you, he pointed to all of us sitting around him, are fortunate to go to school, you must make the effort to actually read books. I felt like Grandpa had conveyed a message to me. We were the lucky few who were blessed with good education, and so we should read books. There are many children in the world who do not have a privilege to go to school and therefore cannot read or write. Instead, their only path to wisdom is through the tradition of storytelling. And so, from that day on, I decided to put my efforts into reading books, the very habit Grandpa had cultivated all his life. That evening, we were to be taken to the market along with my grandma, uncles, and aunts. We looked forward to the outing as we knew we would be treated to some delicious roadside snacks. But for some reason, I did not feel like going out. I just wanted to spend time with Grandpa. When all my cousins had left, I hurried to the library to find my grandpa. He was sitting in his chair, engrossed in some books spread on the table. When he looked up, he was surprised to see me standing all alone. "Why did you not go to the market?" I quietly said, "Grandpa, I want to see your books." He had a smile on his face as if to say, "Okay, my dear little one, welcome to the world of books." Over the next 1 hour, he took me through every rack he had organized. He opened some of the books he held so dear and showed me the notes contained in each one of them. What really attracted me was the number of books he had ancient Indian wisdom. He had everything from Ramayana, Mahabharata and Upanishads to fables of Panchatantra. I realized then where he got all his stories from. Suddenly a question hit me and I asked him, "Which of these books is your favorite, Grandpa?" "Kautilya's Arthashastra," he replied instantaneously. "What is that?" I wondered. Reading my mind, Grandpa picked up the book and led me back to the table. Kautilya was also known as Chanakya. Soon a new world of stories began unfold before me.